Hello students,
In this lecture, we will discuss the basic concepts of internal combustion engine and air standard cycle. These are few of the books that are worth recommendation to be read for internal combustion engine. There are two types of thermodynamical cycles, heat engine cycles and refrigeration cycles. Heat engine cycles are the thermodynamical cycles which produces certain power with heat input, whereas refrigeration cycles consume power but they are going to give us cooling effect in an enclosed space. Now heat engine cycles or power producing cycles can be classified as internal combustion engines and external combustion engines. In the case of internal combustion engine, working substance mix with the fuel, whereas in the case of external combustion engine, fuel do not mix with the working substance of the cycle. Now these IC engines or external combustion engines, they are classified as rotary or reciprocating engines. The examples of IC engines are open cycle gas turbine, Wankel engine, gasoline engine, diesel engine, whereas the examples of external combustion engines include steam engine, Stirling engine, steam turbine and closed cycle. If we discuss the application of engines, whether they are internal combustion engine or external combustion engine, the applications include automotive, marine engines, aircraft engines, apart from the experimental space vehicles, industrial power. This is cross section of a spark ignition engine. Cylinder block and crankcase are the two structural units of an engine. They are either built separately and then connected together, or they are built integrally. Cylinder block houses all the cylinders of an engine, whereas crankshaft lies in the crankcase. Because it houses the crankshaft, that is why it is known as crankcase. But it also houses several other auxiliary devices like lubricating oil pump, water pump, wall timing gears and many more auxiliary devices. In the case of spark ignition engine, air and fuel mixture is prepared with the help of carburetor in a requisite ratio, which is inducted in the cylinder during the suction stroke. Now, during the compression stroke, this air-fuel mixture is being compressed, and at the end of compression stroke, spark is generated with the help of spark plug mechanism, which initiates the combustion. Slowly the combustion propagates and it produces high pressure gases which propels the crankshaft of the engine and produces power. Then the products of combustion or exhaust gases are scavenged out of the engine through exhaust manifold. Manifold is nothing but complex pipes are known as manifold. So through inlet manifold, air fuel mixture rushes into the cylinder, whereas exhaust manifold facilitates the scavenging of the products of combustion or exhaust gases. Piston reciprocates inside the cylinder, and the piston is connected to the small end of connecting rod with the help of gudgeon pin or piston pin, and the big end of the connecting rod is mounted on the crankshaft. Connecting rod is having somewhat angular motion, Now we want to discuss the important terms associated with the IC engine. Top dead center and bottom dead center are the terms that need to be discussed first of all. Top dead center and bottom dead center, as they are abbreviated as TDC and BDC, they are the extreme positions to which piston travel during any of the stroke. Top dead center is defined as the extreme position to which piston travels during compression stroke and exhaust stroke, whereas the bottom dead center is the extreme position to which piston travels during suction stroke and expansion stroke. In the case of vertical cylinder, these centers are defined as top dead center and bottom dead center, whereas in the case of horizontal engine, they are defined as inner dead center and outer dead center. The linear distance between TDC and BDC is known as stroke length. These centers are known as dead centers because they do not move, they are stationary. The inner diameter of the cylinder is known as bore. The cross-sectional area of the cylinder when multiplied with the stroke length gives us swept volume or stroke volume. So the piston travels from top dead center to bottom dead center or bottom dead center to top dead center during any of the stroke. Now the volume remains beyond that is defined as clearance volume. So clearance volume is nothing but it is the volume to which the charge, that is air fuel mixture or air, that is confined at the end of compression stroke. There is one more term which is known as compression ratio. Compression ratio is the ratio of two volumes, that is volume at the beginning of compression stroke and the volume after the or at the end of compression stroke. So if we say that compression ratio of the engine is 6, it means the volume of the charge or air fuel mixture, it is reduced to 1/6 of the volume that was at the beginning of the compression. Another term, cubic capacity or engine capacity, is nothing but it is the total swept volume of all the cylinders of an engine taken together. There are several criterion on the basis of which the engines are classified. The engines are classified on the basis of engine basic engine design as reciprocating engine or rotary engine. On the basis of operating cycle, the engines are defined as Otto cycle, Diesel cycle and Dual cycle. Petrol engines or spark ignition engines work on Otto cycle, in which heat addition takes place at constant volume, whereas low speed diesel engines operate on diesel cycle, in which heat addition takes place at constant pressure. In the case of dual cycle, which is also known as limited pressure cycle, the combustion or heat addition is taking place partly at constant volume and partly at constant pressure. And high speed diesel engines basically operate on dual cycle. On the basis of number of strokes required to complete the working cycle, we classify engines as 4-stroke engines and 2-stroke engines. In the case of 4-stroke engines, there are 4 strokes of the piston, or you can say 2 revolutions of the crankshaft. Whereas in the case of 2-stroke engines, all the processes, be it suction, compression, expansion and exhaust, they are completed in 2 strokes of the piston or 1 revolution of the crankshaft. On the basis of fuel used, we classify engines as petrol engine, diesel engine, CNG engines, LPG engines and alcohol engines. On the basis of fuel supply and mixture preparation, we classify engines as carbureted engines and fuel injected engines. Basically, spark ignition engine or petrol engines are the carbureted engines in which we are having a carburetor, which is nothing but a device which is preparing the mixture of air and fuel in the requisite ratio, which is basically inducted into the cylinder during the suction stroke. In the case of fuel injected engines, which is basically diesel engine, only air is being inducted into the cylinder during suction stroke. This air is being compressed during suction stroke, and at the end of compression stroke, theoretically, fuel droplets in the form of fine spray are injected in the cylinder, which comes in contact with the high temperature air. On the basis of method of ignition, we classify engines as spark ignition engine and compression ignition engines. Spark ignition engines are basically petrol engines. In the case of spark ignition engine, air and fuel mixture that has been prepared by the carburetor rushes into the cylinder during suction stroke. This mixture is compressed during compression stroke. So, during compression, the temperature as well as the pressure of the mixture increases. Now, the temperature is increasing, but even then, it is still lower than the self-ignition temperature of the fuel. So, to ignite this mixture, spark ignition mechanism is employed, and at the end of compression stroke, theoretically, spark is getting ignited. This spark is igniting the mixture and the combustion propagates. In the case of compression ignition engine, only air is being inducted into the cylinder during the suction stroke. This air is being compressed, so the pressure and temperature of the air is increasing. The temperature is so high that it even exceeds the self-ignition temperature of the fuel. Let me tell you, the compression ratio of compression ignition engine is quite high as compared to the spark ignition engine. So the temperature is quite high and it even exceeds the self-ignition temperature of the fuel, that is diesel. So when the fuel is injected in the form of fine spray into the cylinder, this comes into contact with the high temperature air and the mixture is ignited, fuel is ignited, and combustion starts off. So in the case of compression ignition engines, the ignition is basically taking place by the virtue of compression. That is why they are known as compression ignition engine. On the basis of method of cooling, engines are classified as air cooled engines and water cooled engines. Air cooling is employed basically in small capacity engines in which heat dissipation rate is quite low, whereas water cooling is employed in the case of high capacity engines in which heat dissipation rate is quite high and air alone is not sufficient to take away the heat. On the basis of cylinder arrangement, we classify engines as inline engine, V engine, radial engine, opposed piston engine. Now, inline engine is basically IC engine with all cylinders aligned in one row and having no offset. inline engine is considerably easier to build than a horizontally opposed engine or V engine. V engine is a common configuration for IC engine in which cylinders and pistons are aligned in two separate planes or banks so that they appear to be in a V shape when viewed along the axis of crankshaft. The radial engine is a reciprocating type internal combustion engine configuration in which the cylinders radiate outward from a central crankcase like the spokes of a wheel. And opposed piston engine is a piston engine in which each cylinder has a piston at both ends and no cylinder head. The diagram for these configurations I will show you in the next slide. On the basis of method of governing, the engines are classified as quantity governing or quality governing engines. In the quantity governed engines, the quantity of air fuel mixture varies with the change in load or speed of the engine. This quantity governing takes place in case of petrol engines, in which as the load or speed varies, the quantity of air fuel mixture varies, keeping the ratio between air and fuel to be almost constant. Whereas in the case of quality governing, which takes place in case of diesel engines, as the load or speed varies, the amount of fuel varies, keeping the quantity of air to be almost constant. So in the case of quality governing engines, which takes place in diesel engines, the quality of the mixture varies. Whereas in the case of quantity governed engines, the quality of mixture remains almost constant. It is the quantity of the mixture that varies in the case of quantity governed engines. Based on the applications, we classify engines as automotive engines, marine engines, aircraft engines, industrial engines, prime movers for electrical generators. There are various other criterion on which engines can be classified, like on the basis of valve, port design and location. We classify engine as I head or L head. Moreover, on the basis of type of charge of engine, we classify engines as homogeneous and stratified engines. Further, on the basis of combustion chamber design, we classify engine as open chamber or divided chamber engines. We are going to take up these classifications, mainly the last three, in the subsequent lectures when we will be dealing with the combustion in SI engine, CI engines and other chapters. So these are the line diagrams, or you can say engine diagrams of engine configuration of inline engine, V engine, radial engine and opposed piston engine. And these are the diagrams of L head and I head engines. Now we will discuss the derivation of air strain efficiency of Otto cycle, diesel cycle and dual cycle. There are two types of cycles when we discuss Otto cycle, diesel cycle and dual cycle. One is thermodynamic cycle and another is mechanical cycle. Mechanical cycle is basically composed of suction stroke, compression stroke, expansion stroke and exhaust stroke. Means mechanical cycle includes the processes in which there is movement of piston. Whereas thermodynamical cycle starts from the initiation of compression. So, thermodynamical cycle consists of compression process, heat addition process, expansion process, and heat rejection process. It does not involve suction and exhaust. Suction and exhaust are part of mechanical cycle, whereas heat addition and heat rejection are not involved in mechanical cycle. One thing more, from the starting of compression, that is from point one, that is compression process, heat addition process, expansion process, heat rejection process, and again to the point one. A constant mass of working substance is there inside the cylinder. So this process, or this these processes can be modeled as a control mass system, that is a closed system, so that the non-flow work can be calculated as PdV, integration of PdV, because that makes our analysis simpler. And as the system has been modeled as closed system, therefore the energy calculation can be done easily by the first law, that is with the help of equation del Q is equal to du plus del W. So basically, from the point one to the point one again, that is involving process 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, the system can be modeled as closed system, and this is basically the thermodynamic cycle. If we want to discuss all the processes that are covered in mechanical as well as thermodynamic cycle, so let us begin. 0 to 1 is suction taking place at constant pressure. Then 1 to 2, it is reversible adiabatic compression. And I have told you in the engineering thermodynamics syllabus subject that the process which is reversible and adiabatic is isentropic. So I think you are able to recall this. Then heat addition is taking place at constant volume, means combustion has initiated. Then followed by that is reversible adiabatic, that is isentropic expansion, during which we get power and pressure starts decreasing. Then heat rejection is taking place at constant volume, and from 1 to 0 it is the exhaust process. So the products of combustion or exhaust gases are thrown out of the cylinder. But mind it, the suction and exhaust processes are not shown on the thermodynamic cycle. Now you can draw TS diagram for these processes. As you know that isentropic processes can be shown by vertical lines. So 1 and 2, 3 and 4 processes, that is 1 and 2, 3 and 4, they are the isentropic processes and they have been shown by the vertical line. Whereas constant volume processes are shown by inclined curve on the TS diagram having slope with the positive x-axis. Now, when we are deriving the expression for air standard efficiency, let me tell you that as the working substance is air only, instead of fuel plus air plus residual gases, several parameters like Cp, Cv, gamma, R, they are assumed to be constant throughout the range of operation. Range of operation means the temperature varies from
300 केल्विन टू 2000 और 2500 केल्विन और सो और इवन हायर डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द कंप्रेशन रेशियो ऑफ द इंजन एंड मेनी अदर फैक्टर्स. एंड द प्रेशर इज वेरिंग फ्रॉम ऑलमोस्ट 1 bar और इवन स्लाइटली लोअर 270 और 80 bar और हायर डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द कैपेसिटी ऑफ इंजन एंड कंप्रेशन रेशियो एंड मेनी अदर फैक्टर्स. सो यू कैन सी द रेंज ऑफ ऑपरेशन 1 bar 270 और 80 bar और यू कैन से टेम्परेचर 300 केल्विन टू 2000 केल्विन और 2500 केल्विन. सो इवन देन दीज पैरामीटर सी पी सी वी गामा आर अज्यूम टू बी कॉन्स्टेंट. सो दैट इज द अजम्पशन मेनली टू सिंप्लीफाई आर इवेल्युएशन ऑफ एफिशंसी. मोर ओवर इट इज ऑल्सो अज्यूम दैट देर इज नो डिसइंटीग्रेशन ऑफ द वर्किंग सब्सटांस थ्रू आउट द रेंज ऑफ ऑपरेशन. सो ऑल दीज अजम्पशंस आर बेसिकली टू सिंप्लीफाई आवर असेसमेंट ऑफ एफिशंसी. देर इज वन मोर टर्म मीन इफेक्टिव प्रेशर हुज डेराइवेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस जस्ट आफ्टर एयर स्टैंड एफिशंसी. मीन इफेक्टिव प्रेशर इज नथिंग बट इट इज द कॉन्स्टेंट मीन इफेक्टिव प्रेशर दैट इज एक्टिंग ऑन द पिस्टन ऑफ ए हाइपोथेटिकल इंजन दैट इज प्रोड्यूसिंग पावर इक्वलेंट और इक्वल टू एन एक्चुअल इंजन. एज यू नो दैट इन द केस ऑफ एक्चुअल इंजन द प्रेशर वेरीज एंड इट वेरीज ड्रास्टिकली. मीन्स इफ यू टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ फोर स्ट्रोक इंजन लेट मी टेल यू द प्रेशर इज वेरिंग फ्रॉम 1 bar और इवन लोअर देन टू 70 और 80 bar. बिकॉज इन द फोर स्ट्रोक इंजन ऑल द प्रोसेसेस विल टेक प्लेस इन द टू रिवॉल्यूशंस ऑफ द क्रैंकशाफ्ट और यू कैन से 720 डिग्री ऑफ क्रैंक ट्रेवल. सो द प्रेशर इज वेरिंग से फ्रॉम 1 bar टू 80 bar एंड देन ड्यूरिंग एक्सपेंशन स्ट्रोक इट अगेन रिड्यूसेस एंड इट फर्दर रिड्यूसेस ड्यूरिंग द एग्जॉस्ट स्ट्रोक. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी टेक अप द असेसमेंट ऑफ एयर स्टैंड एफिशिएंसी. फॉर दिस वी अज्यूम यूनिट मास ऑफ एन आइडियल गैस इन ए पिस्टन सिलेंडर अरेंजमेंट विच इज अंडरगोइंग ऑल द फोर प्रोसेसेस ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक साइकिल. नाउ फॉर द यूनिट मास ऑफ एन आइडियल गैस द हीट सप्लाइड एट कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम विल बी इक्वल टू सी वी डी टी दैट इज टी थ्री माइनस टी टू. वाई सो? बिकॉज वी हैव assumed it to be a closed system, so definitely del q is equal to du plus del w is going to be our energy equation. And when volume is constant during heat addition process, it means work done will be zero, pdv work will be zero. So heat transfer is equal to change in internal energy and that is equal to cv dt. So cv into t3 minus t2 is the heat added. Similarly, heat rejection takes place at constant volume, so heat QL is equal to CV into T4 minus T1. Thermal efficiency is equal to work done upon heat supplied, or you can say work done can be made equal to heat supplied minus heat rejected. So what we get? 1 minus heat rejected upon heat supplied. So our expression becomes that is shown in equation 3. As we take T1 common in the numerator and T2 common from the denominator, our expression becomes as shown in equation number 4. Now we discuss all the processes one by one. Process 1 to 2 is adiabatic compression. So the relation between temperature and volume is T2 upon T1 is equal to V1 upon V2 raised to power gamma minus 1, that is equal to R raised to power gamma minus 1, where R is compression ratio. As I have told you earlier, R is equal to V1 upon V2, that is compression ratio. Similarly, the relation between the pressure and volume is equal to P2 upon P1 is equal to V1 upon V2 raised to power gamma, that is equal to R raised to power gamma, shown by equation. There is one more parameter, which is alpha, and that is pressure ratio. So that is alpha is equal to P3 upon P2, and that is also equal to T3 upon T2 because volume is constant. So gas law is applicable, P into V upon T is equal to constant. That is what we have applied over here. Process 3 to 4 is adiabatic expansion. So P3 upon P4, that is equal to V4 upon V3 raised to power gamma. So now, as you know, that from 4 to 1 volume is constant, so V4 is equal to V1, and volume is constant also from 2 to 3, that is heat addition process. So V3 is equal to V2. So that expression becomes V1 upon V2 raised to power gamma, that is equal to R raised to power gamma. Similarly, T3 upon T4 is also equal to V4 upon V3 raised to power gamma minus 1, and which is also equal to V1 upon V2 raised to power gamma minus 1. So it becomes T3 upon T4 is equal to R raised to power gamma minus 1. Now, as heat rejection is taking place at constant volume, V4 is equal to V1. So from the equation 5 and 7, we get T2 upon T1 is equal to T3 upon T4. By cross multiplication, we can infer that T4 upon T1 is equal to T3 upon T2. Substituting these values in equation 5 of 5 and 8 in equation 4, the expression for air standard efficiency yield us 1 minus 1 upon R raised to power gamma minus 1. So basically, the expression of air standard efficiency is depending upon the compression ratio. If we want to find out P4 upon P2, so that can be written as P4 upon P3 into P3 upon P2, that is equal to 1 upon R raised to power gamma into alpha. Now, if we want to find out mean effective pressure is nothing but it is basically work done upon swept volume. Because we know that mean effective pressure is as work done upon swept volume. From where this expression is coming? That is quite simple. Work done is equal to PdV. So P is equal to work done upon dV, that is swept volume. Now, first of all, we want to find out work done. So work done is nothing but the area enclosed by geometrical entity or geometrical figure of the cycle on PV diagram. That is net cycle diagram area that is representing the work. So here, if we see this diagram, the area bounded by curve 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 within this curve, that is representing its work. So what we are going to do, the area under the curve 3, 4 minus the area enclosed by the curve under the curve 1, 2, that is going to give you the area within the enclosed diagram or enclosed figure, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So that has been represented by equation number 11. That is P3 V3 minus P4 V4 upon gamma minus 1 minus P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon gamma minus 1. Now what we do, dividing both numerator and denominator by P2 V2, we get work done is equal to the P2 V2 into alpha minus 1 into R raised to power gamma minus 1 upon gamma minus 1 into R raised to power gamma minus 1, the expression shown in 12. What we have done basically over here
we have reduced the entire expression for work done in terms of pressure, volume, alpha, gamma, and R. And these pressure terms also we will reduce in the terms of P1 V1. And finally, we will be having the expression in the terms of P1, the initial pressure, alpha, R, and gamma. That is what we are going to do. Now we know swept volume is equal to V1 minus V2. Because V1 upon V2 is equal to R, so we have written RV2 minus V2. So our expression becomes what has been shown in equation number 13. Now, as I told you, MEP, mean effective pressure, is equal to work done upon swept volume. So the expression becomes as shown in equation number 14. As I have told you earlier, in the terms of P1, that is initial pressure, R, alpha, gamma. So all the students are required to work out these derivations for air strain efficiency and mean effective pressure. If they get any, they can ask me. They can write their problems through mail. Now this is diesel cycle. Diesel cycle is basically having heat addition at constant pressure. All the other processes are similar to that in auto cycle. And one more difference that lies between diesel cycle and auto cycle is that diesel cycle is having higher compression ratio than an auto cycle. So the thermodynamic cycle begins from point one. So reversible adiabatic isentropic compression of the working substance is taking place. Then heat addition takes place at constant pressure. Then reversible adiabatic, or that is isentropic expansion of the working substance, is taking place. Then heat rejection at constant volume. Similarly, all the processes have been shown on TS diagram. So isentropic processes will be shown by vertical lines, whereas constant pressure and constant volume, both curves will be inclined curves. The difference lies in that constant volume curve is having more slope than constant pressure curve on this diagram. Now, similar type of exercise we are going to do for the evaluation of air strain efficiency and mean effective pressure for a diesel cycle. In the diesel cycle, heat addition is taking place at constant pressure. So for the unit mass of an ideal gas, heat supplied is equal to Cp into T3 minus T2. Why heat transfer is equal to CpTT for an ideal gas during constant pressure process, that we are going to discuss in our unit 3 dealing with the Maxwell relations. Now for the constant volume heat rejection, the amount of heat rejected is CvdT, that is CvT4 minus T1. Thermal efficiency, which is equal to 1 minus QL upon QH, is shown by the equation 3. Now dividing numerator and denominator by CV, what we get is shown on the slide. Now dividing numerator and denominator by T1, we get the expression as shown in equation number 4. Now we discuss all the processes one by one. For adiabatic compression process, the relation between the temperature and volume is shown, and what we get is T2 upon T1 is equal to R raised to power gamma minus 1. This is similar as we have done in the case of auto cycle. And P2 upon P1 is equal to R raised to power gamma, where R is compression ratio. Heat addition is taking place at constant pressure, and there is we introduce a new term which is known as cutoff ratio, which is an important parameter in the determination of air strain efficiency of diesel cycle. And this cutoff ratio is nothing but ratio of the volume after heat addition and before heat addition. So V3 upon V2, and that is also equal to T3 upon T2, because
प्रेशर रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट. प्रोसेस 3 to 4 इज रिवर्सिबल एडियाबेटिक एक्सपेंशन. सो P3 अपॉन P4 इज इक्वल टू V4 अपॉन V3 रेज़ टू पावर गामा. एंड सिंस V4 इज इक्वल टू V1 एंड V3 इज इक्वल टू रो टाइम्स V2 एज गिवन इन द इक्वेशन नंबर 6, वी फाइनली गेट द एक्सप्रेशन एज R अपॉन रो रेज़ टू पावर गामा. सिमिलरली T3 अपॉन T4 बिकम्स R अपॉन रो रेज टू पावर गामा माइनस 1. हीट रिजेक्शन इज टेकिंग प्लेस एट कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम, सो V4 इज इक्वल टू. नाउ वी एक्सप्रेस ऑल द टेम्परेचर रेशियोज इन इक्वेशन 4 इन टर्म्स ऑफ R, रो एंड गामा. सो T2 अपॉन T1 इज इक्वल टू R रेज टू पावर गामा माइनस 1 एज वी हैव एक्सप्रेस्ड अर्लियर. T3 अपॉन T2 इज इक्वल टू रो दैट वी हैव ऑल्सो एक्सप्रेस्ड अर्लियर. नाउ T4 अपॉन T1 दैट कैन बी रिटन एज T4 अपॉन T3 इंटू T3 अपॉन T2 इंटू T अपॉन T1. So that becomes equal to rho raised to power gamma as shown in the equation 8. So you can work out this. Now the expression for air standard efficiency is equal to 1 minus rho raised to power gamma minus 1 upon gamma r raised to power gamma minus 1 into rho minus 1. So you can see कट ऑफ रेशियो इज प्लेइंग एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल अपार्ट द कंप्रेशन रेशियो इन द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर एयर स्टैंड एफिशिएंसी ऑफ. नाउ फॉर द वर्क डन, बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आउट मीन इफेक्टिव प्रेशर एंड दैट कैन बी डन बाय द फॉर्मूला वर्क डन डिवाइडेड बाय स्वेप्ट वॉल्यूम गिव्स मीन इफेक्टिव प्रेशर. सो द एरिया विद इन दिस ज्योमेट्रिकल डायग्राम वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट. So that is equal to P2 into V3 minus V2, the area of the rectangle, plus area under the curve 3-4 minus the area under the curve 1-2. That is going to give you the area within the enclosed diagram 1-2-3-4-1. So that is equal to P2 into V3 minus V2 plus P3 V3 minus P4 V4 upon gamma minus 1 minus P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon gamma minus 1. So now similar type of exercise we are going to do. We divide both numerator and denominator by P2 V2 and we try to get this expression in terms of P1 rho gamma. Swept volume we have expressed in the similar way as we did in earlier in the case of auto cycle, and finally we get the expression for MEP in the terms of P1, R, gamma and rho. This is dual cycle on which high speed diesel engines operate. So the process 1-2 is reversible adiabatic, that is isentropic compression of working substance. Then heat addition takes place at constant volume, followed by the heat addition at constant pressure. Then reversible adiabatic or isentropic expansion of the working substance is taking place, and finally heat is rejected at constant volume. So all the processes have been shown on the TS diagram. The isentropic processes have been shown by the vertical lines, whereas constant pressure and constant volume curves have been shown by inclined curves. So constant volume curve is having more slope than constant pressure process, that is evident on the TS diagram. Now for the unit mass of an ideal gas, heat supplied is equal to Cv into T3 minus T2 plus Cp into T4 minus T3, because heat addition is taking place partly at constant volume and partly at constant pressure. Heat rejected is equal to CVdT, that is CV into T5 minus T1. So the thermal efficiency, which is equal to 1 minus QL upon QH, becomes as what is shown in equation number 3. dividing numerator and denominator first by CV and then by T1, we get the expression as shown in equation number 4. So we are having different temperature ratios in the equation number 4. So now what we have to do? We have to find out the values of these temperature ratios shown. So we describe all the processes one by one. Adiabatic compression, similar to the previous both cases, we are having T2 upon T1 is equal to R raised to power gamma minus 1 and P2 upon P1 is equal to R raised to power gamma. Now process 2 to 3 heat addition is taking place at constant volume. We define here the term alpha pressure ratio as we did in the case of auto cycle. So that is equal to P3 upon P2 and that is also equal to T3 upon T2. Process 3 to 4 heat addition is taking place at constant pressure. Here we define the term cutoff ratio as we did in the case of diesel cycle. So that cutoff ratio is equal to V4 upon V3 and that is equal to T4 upon T3. 4 to 5 is adiabatic expansion process. So P4 upon P5 is equal to V5 upon V4 raised to power gamma. Since 5 to 1 is constant volume process, so V5 is equal to V1 and V4 can be written as rho times V2. So P4 upon P5 is equal to R upon rho raised to power gamma. And similarly, T4 upon T5 is also equal to R upon rho raised to power gamma minus 1. Also, P5 upon P2 is equal to P5 upon P4 into P4 upon P3 into P3 upon P2. So that becomes rho upon R raised to power gamma minus 1 into alpha. Now, expressing all the temperature ratios in equation 4 in terms of R, alpha, gamma and rho, what we get is T2 upon T1 is equal to R raised to power gamma minus 1, T3 upon T1 is equal to alpha into R raised to power gamma minus 1, T4 upon T1 becomes rho into alpha into R raised to power gamma minus 1. And T5 upon T1 becomes equal to alpha into R raised to power gamma. So this is nothing but simplification, simple mathematics. Substituting the values of equation 5, 9, 10 and 11 in equation 4, what we get is, we get the expression of air strength efficiency in terms of R, gamma, alpha and rho, as shown in the equation number 12. Now here also what we are going to do to determine the expression for mean effective pressure for dual cycle, we want to find out the work done. That is, we want to find out the area enclosed by this geometrical figure, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. So that will be equal to the area of the rectangle, that is P3 into V4 minus V3 plus area under the curve 4 to 5 minus the area under the curve 1 to 2. So that is P3 into V4 minus V3 plus P4 V4 minus P5 V5 upon gamma minus 1 minus P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon gamma minus 1. Dividing both numerator and denominator by P2 V2, we get the expression of work done as shown in the slide. So what we have to do, we have to derive the entire terms for the expression of mean effective pressure in terms of P1, R, alpha, rho and gamma. So this is what we have finally achieved over here. We have achieved the expression for mean effective pressure in terms of P1, R, rho, gamma, alpha. So this is